I recently did a $5,000 monster PC build that I called Alan Lake, and you can check that out in the description below or in the annotation on the screen now. And I did come into some trouble with the Samsung 950 Pro M.2 drives. Stick around to see how I made them work with my Z170 board. So the first thing that you'll see when you start up your computer is to press F2 or the delete key, and that will get you into the BIOS or the UEFI setup. Once you're in there, you'll be presented with this screen. And what you'll need to do is press F6 to go to the advanced setup. Now the first thing you'll want to do is go to the advanced menu and go to storage. Once you're there, check that the SATA controller is set to enabled. The SATA mode is AHCI. Almost didn't get that. And the hard drive smart mode is set to enabled as well. And the SATA 3 mode is AHCI as well. Then if you scroll down the list, you'll see that the M1, M2 and M3 slots are not populated. So our next stop will be the boot menu. So you'll see my system is already configured to boot from the M.2 drive. And you can see this by seeing that Windows Boot Manager is boot option 1. But because we're starting from scratch, what you'll need to do is scroll all the way down to the bottom of this page and choose CSM, which stands for Compatibility Support Module. Once you're in there, you'll see CSM as enabled. Now, in order to boot from a UEFI USB drive with Windows 10 on it, we need to select this and change it to disabled. Now, if you'd like to know how to make a UEFI bootable Windows 10 installation USB drive, then leave me a comment down below. And if I get enough interest, I'll make a new video on that. Now, the other three options that you see here, you will need to change those to UEFI only. This will allow things like your 4K monitor, if you have one, to support displaying the BIOS or UEFI in 4K resolution. So once you've hit disabled on CSM, we can now go to exit and save changes and exit. Now make sure that you've got your USB drive plugged in with your UEFI bootable Windows 10 installation and press F11 to go into the boot menu. Now from here you can choose USB drive and you can start your Windows 10 installation. Your M.2 drive will appear and everything will be great. Now after you have done the installation, what you will need to do is go back into the BIOS and change the CSM setting to enabled. Save changes and exit and you're away. I thought this shit was meant to be easy. Now I didn't realize there was so much you had to do to make these M.2 drives bootable. And it took a little bit of research to actually find out how to make this work on the Z170 motherboard. Fair enough, this technology is really, really fresh and really, really new, so there's not a lot of documentation out there on how to make these work. So hopefully this has helped you with your M.2 drive and your Z170 board. Well, that's it for another video. I really hope you liked it. If you did, make sure you give me a big thumbs up and maybe even leave a comment down below. If you do enjoy the content that I'm providing here, please make sure that you subscribe to my channel because it really helps me a lot. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Bye! Really?